Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on a High Elf Chariot. I'm going to keep working on the back armor plating of this lion here today. I wanted to show you guys something real quick here first, though. This is one of those sort of mid-miniature painting possible transitions. I don't know if you can see it or not. Let's back out just a touch more. A little bit more. Come on. Focus, please. There you go. Okay. Do you see that little line right there in the ear? That, I'm guessing, is from some of the time, I don't know when I dropped the miniature. All right, it probably landed on the ear, and there's a little crack right there. Now, I've got two choices. I can either repair it and kind of cover it up with a little bit of paint, or I can break it off and paint over the white space that will be there, that'll be kind of like the new top of the ear, and just treat it as sort of a battle damage type thing. Which to do, I don't know. Right now, I'm kind of leaning towards the battle damage, because of the two, that is definitely the lesser of two evils. It's not going to require nearly as much work to get done, and I don't have to mess around with trying to get glue into a really small space. So, that's probably what I'm going to choose, but for right now, I'm just going to leave it as is. If it falls off on its own, then my decision's made for me. Otherwise, I'll make the decision at a later time. But I just wanted to kind of show you guys that, because some of you may experience the same type thing on your own miniatures. When you go to paint them or something, you might knock off an arm. You might, I've knocked off so many skeleton arms over the years, just dry brushing, that you get to the point where you're like, you know what, I'm not fixing them anymore. They're just, it's battle damage. There's also a little bit of string area here on the top of the mane. What I like to do when I get something like that is just take a nice dry brush, and I do mean a dry brush, but a dry brush with stiff bristles, and just sort of dab at it and kind of get it off there. What I'm trying to do is work it free enough to where I can grab it either with my fingernails, like I've got now, there we go, or a pair of tweezers. Now, I don't know if you can see this or not. Let's see if you can see it there on my finger. Do you see? You might be able to see it against the black right there. I'm going to try and hold my finger really, really still so that YouTube will focus up for me. Maybe you can see it, maybe you can't, but you'll occasionally find stuff like that on your miniature. My favorite way to get rid of them, like I said, loosen them up with a dry brush, and then either pull them off with your fingernails or a nice small pair of tweezers. But let's get back to our painting and see what we can do here. I've got my next color mixed up here, this sort of intermediary steel kind of color. And I'm going to bring this highlight way down. Way down. Way down, way down in my soul, down in my soul. Sorry, every now and again I'll get something stuck in my head and I'll start singing. You'll have to forgive me, but that's all right. It's good to sing every now and again, as long as it's a good song. Not like, you know, gangster rap or something weird. That's something I gotta tell you, I miss. I miss old rap. The modern day stuff is just so, I mean, aside from the fact that it's very degrading to females and stuff like that, it's just not any good. You know, you go back and you listen to stuff like Digital Underground and the really old, like Sir Mix-a-Lot, stuff like that, and it's just, it's such better stuff. And yes, I realize Sir Mix-a-Lot was somewhat degrading, but not to the nearly the level of stuff nowadays, but just such a better quality of music. Anyway, I shall get off my soapbox, because otherwise I'll be on it forever. Gently paint That's what we got to do here. Gently paint. Boy, I am liking this. I really do. This is a great little mini. Can't wait to be done with it. See how the final product turns out. I realize I got a whole nother lion to do, as well as a chariot and a couple of dudes. But, this is just a heap of fun. Okay. And then we'll touch this area here. Bring that highlight down there. Okay, great. Now, I'm going to get a little bit more paint. And we'll come to this one here. And we're going to start at the top and work our way down. That way we know exactly where we're going. Know exactly what we've done. And there's no confusion as to what I might need to paint and what I haven't painted. Still in frame, yes. So I gotta be careful now because my TV's gone. So I had a TV that the only thing I used it for was panning my camera into to always make sure I was in frame when I did these YouTube videos for you guys, because when we do the YouTube stuff, I don't have a camera person here. The AV input on the TV died, got real loose, and the cable wouldn't stay in it anymore, and so finally just ditched it. So I'm working off the LCD screen of the camera, which means that it's very difficult to see, and on top of that, all the directions are reversed. So just bear with me until I either get a new TV or figure out an alternate solution. But I don't know what that might be. Alright. A little color there. Some color here. And bringing it up the sides of this. Yeah. Man, look at the difference in the color between those little dots right there that are going to be gold and then the actual armor plating. That is nice and bright. All right. Very, very cool. This is going to look just stunning. Some of these areas I might have to go back in, repaint the dark line on, just to get it to appear again, because I have, unfortunately, covered a couple of them up, and if I fill them in with paint, that's even worse, but it's alright, we can go back and repaint the line, make it look like it's still there at least. You guys are enjoying these. They're fun to do. And they let me get some painting done and some filming done at the same time, which is nice. Plus, you guys get a little insight as to what goes through my mind while I'm painting. Sometimes it's just random ramblings and musings. Sometimes it's actual thought process of, you know, what do I need to do next? Why am I doing what I'm doing? That sort of stuff. And hopefully that's helpful to you as a painter. Okay. Alright, I think we'll call that done as far as that highlight goes. So let's go to the next color now. Got about 5 more minutes on this video, so should be able to get at least one more color on. Trying to keep these all around the 15-minute mark. I know some of them go a little bit over, but ideally, for attention span's sake, namely, 15 minutes is about the maximum. Alright, there we go. And we'll come back and work on the back armor plate first, again, just like we did last time. And I'm going to pull that highlight all about halfway down. Same thing on this side. Tell you what, let me go ahead and do the edge here. That way I'm not turning the miniature around twice. I'll just knock it all out here in one go. Okay, there we go. You know, I could probably, I don't know, but I would venture to guess, I could probably just paint this thing in mithril silver, be done with it. But I don't think it would look as nice. Okay. I think I'm going to need a little bit more paint. I did not pull much of it out of the paint pot. Got to get some of the new Games Workshop paints, I think. Especially my chainmail is wearing somewhat thin. But I'll cross that bridge when it comes. Or I guess I should say when I get to it. Because the bridge ain't moving anywhere. Do here, I'm going to wipe my brush off and try and feather this edge out just a little bit so there's not such a heavy, heavy break line right there between one color and the next. Just makes the blend a little bit more smooth, the transition a little bit more nice, a little bit more natural. Why is my computer making noises? What am I doing? Oh, I'm uploading a video, that's right. I was like, all of a sudden my computer made this really loud sigh like it was very, very tired. But that's okay. It's uploading, so it's doing work, so I can understand why it's tired. Alright, a little bit more color right here on the trim. A little more color. Right here on the trim. Okay, there we go. And let's go to the other side. Now, gosh, this guy just like keeps sinking in quicksand almost inside this blue tack. And I need yet another little dab of paint. Yep, I think this is going to be the final highlight for this particular episode. Otherwise, we're going to hit probably 20-25 minutes if I go all the way. Let's go all the way. Let's go all the way. Yeah. Let's go all the way. Boy, I miss the 80s. What a great, great decade for music. And then I'll do the same thing here I just did. Wipe my brush off and sort of feather this edge out just a little bit. And here towards the bottom. Okay. And then I'll pick up a little bit more paint. And I'll work on this trim area here. There we go. And we'll call it done. All right. Looking good, looking good. Very bright, very shiny. I think this is going to turn out really, really nicely. So that's all I got for you guys today. I hope that you've enjoyed this episode of Watch Me Work. If you have any comments or questions, please leave them down in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you're not already subscribed. I really do appreciate you guys watching. Thank you very, very much. God bless you all. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next video.